Brooks Agnew is a scientist, engineer, and doctor of physics. He spent years studying Arctic weather patterns. He's about to demonstrate the awesome power of this so-called research project. He'll show how HARP's ELF radio waves can actually push around rain clouds in the sky, and in the process, change the weather.
Well, this is a basic cloud chamber. I'm going to make a cloud inside of it, stabilize it, make sure it's all nice and still, and then we're going to move it using HARP impulses.
Weather manipulation, the ability to control the weather in specific areas. Is it possible?
It isn't even remotely possible.
The HARP researchers may not be as candid as they appear. They deny HARP can control the weather. But Dr. Agnew shows investigator Jun Sarpong just how easy the process can be.
When I turn the pulses on, this cloud should move from bottom to top.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you can really see it.
It's almost like there's a wind inside
the chamber. So if this was the sky, you would see rapid movement in the sky.
Right. And this is just a fraction of the power that's used in HARP. We're using about 100 watts in this little cloud chamber. HARP uses a billion watts. So we pushed a couple of cubic feet of cloud vapor in a few seconds. With a billion watts, you could easily move a cloud wherever you wanted to move it using HARP.
It's no coincidence that the United States began building its own mysterious array of antennas in February 1992. They are located in Gokona, Alaska. The project is called HARP.
HARP is the High Frequency Active Auroral Research Project, originally a joint effort of the Air Force and Navy in cooperation with a number of academic institutions.
It is today the world's largest radio broadcasting station, but it's not designed to broadcast for human ears. It uses unique patented ability to focus the energy coming out of the antenna field and injects that energy into a spot at the very top of the atmosphere in a region called the ionosphere.
HARP is comprised of 180 antennas, approximately 72 feet tall, linked together to function as one giant steerable antenna. Steerable because it can aim millions of watts of ELF waves into one tiny patch of the atmosphere.
The amount of energy we're talking about here is 3.6 million watts. To give you an idea of what that is, the largest legal AM radio station in North America is 50,000 watts. HARP is 72,000 50,000 watt radio stations injecting their entire output into a spot that's about 12 miles across by about 2.5 miles deep by about 90 miles up.
This is where HARP is pointing. It's an area located roughly 300 miles from Anchorage. The U.S. military says HARP is merely being used to study the physical and electrical properties and behavior of the ionosphere for both civilian and defense purposes. But another theory has surfaced. The intense energy being beamed into the sky by HARP is actually heating up the atmosphere, causing weather changes.
HARP is being used for weather modification. The military's own record proves it. They've admitted it within their own documents, and yet they still deny it to the public.
Dr. Brooks Agnew has researched ELF wave technology for the past 30 years and is convinced HARP's effect on the ionosphere does alter the weather.
HARP couldn't affect the jet stream directly, but indirectly it could, because if you push the ionosphere out into space, then the stratosphere just under the ionosphere has to move to fill in that gap. When it moves, it could pull the jet stream with it, thus rerouting it hundreds of miles, changing the way water moves through our atmosphere.
Dr. Agnew has devised a demonstration to show how HARP could manipulate the atmosphere.
So what we've done is we've got a cloud generator up here. It's an ultrasonic nebulizer. It's going to create real water particles, just like you would find in a cloud. What we're seeing now is we're actually filling this chamber with microscopic water particles. You can see that it's almost completely filled with water vapor. It's beginning to condense a little bit on the sides, just so that you can see the detail We've got a nice dense fog, just like you were sitting inside a cloud at 50,000 feet.
At the bottom of the cloud chamber, Dr. Agnew has constructed an ELF wave transmitter, a miniature version of HARP.
We're only using 100 watts. It's perfectly safe.
When Dr. Agnew turns on the ELF wave transmitter and begins shooting ELF waves into the simulated cloud, the cloud begins to move up to the top of the chamber, taking the moisture with it.
If you get down low enough, you can actually see a clear layer above the antenna. It is actually pushing these water particles up, and that's exactly how HARP works. What we've done is we've not only pushed the cloud off of the HARP antenna, but as you can see, our cloud is almost completely gone inside. HARP does exactly the same thing. It ionizes the particles, pushes them out into space.
HARP is one of several ELF wave transmitters located all over the globe. The United States owns and operates three of them, one in Gakona, Alaska, another in Fairbanks, Alaska, and one in Arecibo, Puerto Rico. Russia has one in Vasilursky near Nizhny Novgorod, and the European Union has one near Tromsø in Norway. Working in tandem, these transmitters could potentially alter the weather anywhere in the world, changing the jet stream's course entirely, triggering massive rainstorms or droughts. Even hurricane steering would be possible by heating up the atmosphere and building up high-pressure domes that could deflect or change the course of hurricanes. The U.S. government is firm in its position that HARP is just an atmospheric research facility. But is it more than coincidence that since going online, some experts have reported strange weather anomalies, including massive floods, hurricanes, and earthquakes? HARP went online in 1994, and construction continued until 2007. There are reportedly a total of 5 known ionospheric heaters, including HARP, in the world today. There are possibly 20 other ionospheric heaters in existence all over the world. There's no conclusive proof that any of them are being used as weather weapons, though they do have the ability to manipulate the ionosphere. And that brings us to something else. December 2001. Scientists at NASA's Ames Research Center in Palo Alto, California make a discovery. In studying more than 100 earthquakes with magnitudes of 5.0 or greater, they find that almost all of them are preceded by electrical disturbances in the ionosphere. Could there be a connection to HARP or a facility like it?
To say that HARP can artificially excite the ionosphere in such a way to cause an earthquake, well, it alarms me.
Dr. Agnew experienced the power of ELF waves firsthand back in the 1980s. He was hired by an energy company to locate oil and gas using the same kind of ELF waves at much lower frequencies to carry out his search. It's a process called earth tomography,